Hi guys, I wanted to do a video today to show you basically start to finish how to do the print then cut feature. It seems to be a feature that people either aren't aware that you can do or are very confused on how to do it. And it is a very simple process, but there are a few things to remember, things to keep in mind that are a little bit different than if you were just trying to cut out normal paper, vinyl, what have you. So the first thing I want you to keep in mind and be aware of is that you are only able to print out certain sizes of images, and it all depends on what browser you're using. By browser, I mean if you're using Internet Explorer, Google Chrome, Firefox, etc. So I have up here in the background the Cricut website. This shows you right here the sizes of your image, the maximum size that you can print out. So unfortunately, you couldn't print out a huge, you know, mat size image like a 12 by 12. It won't even let you print out on a paper bigger than 8.5 by 11. And then within that paper, you also have to keep your image smaller than 8.5 by 6 on most, 8 by 5.5 on Google Chrome, which is what I'm using. The other thing is that you need to print out on white paper. There is a way to do it with colored paper, and maybe I can make a video to show you that later. But color or pattern paper, it just really messes up the Cricut reading the registration marks. So you really need to use white paper or white material. There's also like printable vinyl, there's magnet sheets, sticker sheets, lots of different things. Like there's printable iron-on. So there's lots of different materials you can use, but they need to be white materials. So I'm going to show you using a Cricut Access library printable image to just show you the basics of how you send it to your printer and how it comes out, what it looks like, that type of thing. So let me go ahead and get started, and then I'll kind of show you how to customize your own image. So I'm just going to filter this to the Cricut Access, and then I'm just going to choose a spring image. Now, a lot of these are just basic files, but what you may notice on some of these is that it has a little printer icon down here, and this means that this is just ready to go, ready to print. Nothing you need to do to make it print ready. You just are ready to go. So I'm just going to go ahead and insert this image. Now, just so it's a little bit easier to see real quickly, I'm going to just set a background color, set my canvas, and just make it like blue. Sometimes I just find that this is a little easier. Let me turn off the grid lines too. Just easier to kind of see the border of these designs. So when you pick a printable from the Cricut library, it's going to give you this attached set, and I don't want you to let the word attached throw you off. And I'll explain that to you later. But right now, a lot of these layers, most of them are hidden. And what it is doing is just printing out this single grouped image. I think the reason it gives you this is maybe like if all you want to do is cut out the banner spring, then you have that option. You can kind of cut out the individual parts, or you can do the whole thing. So yeah, this is what the image looks like. It's ready to go. So all I need to do is click go. Now here's some other things that I want you to be aware of. So you'll see on your map preview that this white area is what you're going to be printing. And as you can see, it's just this 8.5 by 11. And then it gives you these registration marks. And that's why you kind of are constrained to only being able to print out like an 8 by 5.5, like on this, is because it needs to have room for these registration marks. The other thing you may notice over here on the left is that it has this bleed for print then cut. It's automatically going to be checked, and you want to keep that checked, but I'm going to show you what happens if I uncheck it. You're going to see that the image actually shrinks down and it looks a little bit clearer. So before, it maybe looked a little bit fuzzy and thick, but we want it to be that way because we want to give the Cricut a little bit of buffer room in case that you're off by a couple millimeters, your cut. We don't want it to have a white border around the outside of this design, so we actually do want to kind of bleed it out and kind of stretch out those colors so that when it cuts, it's just going to be color on the outside, and I'll show you what that actually looks like. So after you see your preview, then you're just going to hit go, and then it's going to tell you print the page on your home printer before continuing. So we're going to hit print. And then this is the other thing I want you to keep in mind. This may look a little different to you if you have a PC versus a Mac, but you need to make sure that you are choosing, like right now it has fit to page. I want that on, and I want to make sure that this is scaled to 100%. I don't want it to stretch to the page or anything like that. I need it to be like 100% to scale. So let me show you now the process once it prints out of the printer. So this is what your image will look like. It'll print out with these registration marks here in the upper corners. And so what we'll do is insert this into our machine. It's already ready to go, so I'm just going to hit the go button. And then it's going to start reading the registration marks. And don't be alarmed here if we hit kind of pauses at certain points. See, you get a light that turns on and then it'll start kind of just slowly reading each one of these marks. To show you is actually what's left on this paper. Okay, you see how it has kind of the outline of the flowers. You can kind of still see the outside. That's what the bleed is for, so that if for some reason your cut is a little bit off, it doesn't leave a white outline. It just leaves a really smooth, oops, I forgot a piece right there, but you get the idea. So it doesn't leave any kind of white border around the picture. I'll work on that here in a minute. And it also cut out this little inside of the flower. But that's why you need to keep the bleed on, or else you will see kind of a white outline around these things, and it just doesn't look as clean. But that's how that image looks.
Okay, so I'm going to show you if you want to upload a non-printable image. This can be your own if you're doing text, like maybe you're doing like a wedding shower invite or anything like that. So I'm just going to use another Cricut Access library image, and we'll look for spring again. So I'm going to use this little bird because I want to use print, text to kind of show you some things that people, some frequent mistakes, I guess, or some oversights. So one thing to keep in mind, right now this is set to cut. Before I send it to the printer, I need to, if I want to change the colors, if you're picking an image from the library, or if you've uploaded something that maybe you want the colors to change, if I want to do that, I need to do that first. So I'm just like, if I wanted to change the letters, you know, that to yellow, then I can do that before. But once you've got it all set and ready, the only thing you need to do to tell it to print and cut is to flatten the image. We don't need to attach anything. We don't need to weld anything. Well, if you're doing like your own print, like script or anything like that, you do want to weld that before you are. But once you've got your image edited to where you're ready to print it, all we need to do is flatten. So I have this background to kind of illustrate something that a lot of people forget to do, especially when it comes to text. So I'm just going to go ahead and flatten this, and you'll notice it goes from about a 5 or 6 layer to just this single layer. And now it looks, it's printable. It doesn't have the border to cut. But as you can tell, I can still see this blue background through these letters. So what that means is this is going to cut out each of these letters individually, and it's also going to cut out these this inside space. So I'm going to show you what this looks like on this Go screen and show you this. A lot of people see this and they're like, what's wrong with my text right now? It looks so fuzzy and chunky. And this is because I have not attached or flattened this to anything. So all it's going to do is it's giving me that bleed so that it has that buffer to cut out between each of these letters. So let me show you what this looks like when you print it out with before flattening it to another object. So here's this image without having any kind of background, and you'll see that the letters are pretty fuzzy and thick, and because it does have that bleed on. And right now it's going to set to cut around each one of these letters. So here's what the finished product looks like when you don't flatten this to an object. It just cuts out the letters as if we were doing it on vinyl. You can see it kind of messed up the E a little bit. Okay, so a way to get around that, or what I think most people want to do when they're trying to print then cut things that have text, is you need to put something behind this text and flatten it to that first. So I'm going to insert a shape, and we'll just do a circle, and I'm going to stretch this out to a oval here. Let me move that to the back so I can see what I'm doing. Okay, and then if I don't change this color before I flatten it, it is going to print out with this dark black background. So I'm going to switch this to white. And now right now, this the picture is already flattened. The circle is not. And some people might think, well, it's set to cut out this circle, so I should just select all and maybe group them or attach them. No, what you need to do is just hit the flatten. That's all we do is hit flatten, and it flattens these two together to one single layer. And now you can't see through. You have a white background here for these letters, and it's going to just cut out this oval. So let me show you now what that looks like. Okay, here's our final cut. So you'll see as I tear this paper away that all we're left with is just the oval with our pretty print, on the inside. So that looks a lot better than those letters where, especially on paper, the smaller areas can be really pretty fragile and tend to tear fairly easily. So this is a lot better solution, especially when you're using any kind of letters. If you're doing an invitation or anything, this just looks a lot crisper and cleaner and prettier. So one final quick thing I want to note is that you may, if you choose, I'm going to unflatten this so I can separate them. You may, if you choose a Design Space Cricut Access Library image, instead of putting a shape behind it, you may also be able to, it may have this little shadow layer that you can just unhide, change it to white, or even another color if you wanted it to print out in a color. But this is another option that you can flatten these shapes together so that instead of it cutting an oval, it would just kind of cut this shadow layer, which that's a pretty cool look sometimes too. So not every image has this option, especially if you upload your own. They may not have that option. So just check in your layers panel to see. But one final thing too is that if you are having issues with the actual like registration marks being read, there's a lot of different reasons that it may not be reading that. So I would go to the Cricut site and see if any of the troubleshooting questions about print then cut can kind of help you with calibrating or making sure that your print size, your page settings are the correct settings, so just check that out. But if you have any specific questions that I didn't mention, just put it in the comments below. So hopefully this video helped. Have a good day.